Hey guys, a couple of days ago I had made a tweet saying that Game Informer was going to be taking questions from the community because they were going to be doing an interview with Vonderhaar and they wanted to ask those questions. The Blackout beta has just ended and they thought it would be a good idea to ask questions from the community to see what they thought after the beta and see what kind of questions they have moving forward. They did a podcast interview that was a little over 40 minutes. I'll have that link down in the description if you guys want to watch the whole thing. And in this video, I'm just going to go over the questions that I thought were more interesting. Game Informer asked how Vonderhaar was doing after the beta and what he was working on right now, and he said right now he's working on tearing some things apart that the fans were talking about a lot and try to put it back together and see how much they can get done in time for launch. He didn't say specifically what the fans were complaining about, but he did say he was working on one issue regarding tearing something down and rebuilding it. He said he was really blown away with the positive reception of the Blackout beta, and it makes him really emotional to think about it, and he said he was getting a little emotional thinking about it in the podcast even. One of the questions from the community was about the player count. They wanted to know if it was going to be 100 players for the release. He said that he wasn't sure how many players there was going to be in a match for the launch, but they're going to keep cranking it and see how well it will do. They're trying to reach the player count of 115 to match the zombies lore. One of the questions from the community was about new character skins and new weapons, and he said that there will be new weapons added at launch that were not in the beta. He said that there will be future character skins that will be added, and if they create new weapons in the future with DLC or new content, those will be added into the Blackout as well. He said that for the release, they're going to have a feature added where you can turn on the ability for your character to speak in the game. He said there will be a lot of audio improvements with the release, including sound volume changes to the footsteps from your teammates and also enemies. One of the Game Informer guys had a question about auto vacuuming up the ammo. He didn't like that you had to go around and pick up the ammo. Sometimes it interfered with accidentally picking up other guns because they were so closely placed together. Vonderhaar said that auto vacuuming of ammo is never going to be a feature. There's a reason why they make you pick it up. It makes you more aware of your ammo and different types of ammo. They don't want players just running around collecting all the ammo and leaving nothing for anyone else. Someone asked about the friendly fire, if that's going to be an option to be turned off. He said in the main public game, no. We're always going to have friendly fire active, but there could be an option in custom games in the future where you can turn it off. Someone asked about split screen, and he said right now there is no split screen, but they're still working on it, and it's too soon to tell if they can actually do it or not. He said there's a lot going on in the world, and it makes it really difficult to make things render out correctly. Vonderhaar mentioned something about the spectating mode, that there is a new feature with the spectator, and that they have not shown it yet, and it's going to make it a lot more fun for people to spectate. It's going to allow the spectator to be more aware of what's going on in the game than the actual player. They feel like the spectating aspect is an important part of the game, and they want to encourage people to stay and watch till the end of the match, and they're saying that this new feature will encourage people to do that. Vonderhaar said that he is really excited about the future additions to the map that they're going to be making, and they kind of hinted a little bit that there's a lot of ocean out there and a lot of space, so that could be used for some future locations. They asked him if there's going to be any special holiday events like Halloween, and Vonderhaar said that the Zombies Blightfather event was kind of giving us a little bit of an indication of what they're capable of and the things that they're going to be doing. Vonderhaar said that the guys at the studio went through 175 different event-based driven concepts that they have for Blackout that are all different, new, and unique. There was one question from the community about the Blightfather event that was put in the cemetery next to Asylum. They said that killing him was pretty tough and you didn't get really good drops from him, and he admitted saying, yeah, that's true, because they didn't put the drops that he's actually going to drop in the beta, and that will be in the release. And then he hinted that the stuff that the Blightfather will be dropping during the release will maybe allow you to unlock some zombie characters. I had asked a question similar to this, and they didn't ask my question, but this basically answered what I was asking, and it was, how do we start these quests for these zombie characters and unlocking them? So one of them could be that we have to kill the Blightfather, and whatever he drops, we got to pick up and use. There were two questions from two community members that I recognize and know who they are. One of them is Slickkilla, and he asked about the circle closing in. He wanted to know if the circle would ever end up in a zombies location, because during the beta, it never did. He said he's aware of that, and that they're saving that for special events, and the Game Informer guy hinted at maybe Halloween. The other question from the other community member that I know is Zero, and he wanted to know about Black Ops 4 mod tools for PC. Vonderhaar said that there's been no mod tools announced, and he is not authorized to speak on that. And he looked a little uncomfortable when he was answering it, so not sure what's going on there. Someone asked if there's going to be another Blackout map in addition to the one that we've seen in the beta, and he said there is no current plans for a different Blackout map. They need to work on the one that they currently have. The next question was about the progression system, and he said that there are 80 levels in this ranking system, and there's no prestige, so you could go from 1 to 80, and during that, you collect prizes along the way that are character skins. And when you reach the top 80 rank, you'll receive the granddaddy prize of all prizes. The next question was about a custom mode, and he said that they are hoping for a custom mode, that there's a vision for it. Him and his boss both think it's a great idea, and that they are currently working on a bunch of settings that are being set up for it to work. The next question was about Easter eggs, and they wanted to know if there were any Easter eggs that hadn't been found yet in the Blackout map. He said there are many Easter eggs that have not been discovered in Blackout, and they were a little disappointed that they weren't found, but then again they said they were happy because they know they had done a good job. Then he goes on to talk about Asylum and that he had seen some YouTube videos and that he was aware that there had been a couple that were solved. One of them that he is aware of that he hinted at was the toilet that you flush three times in Asylum, and it plays the Lullaby of a Dead Man Easter egg song. So if he's talking about Easter eggs and he's saying that there has been several that have not been found, and then he mentions an interactable Easter egg like the toilets, it makes me wonder if these mini Easter eggs that have not been found are interactable as well, or are they just visual Easter eggs? There was a question from one of the community members about the original name for Blackout, and Vonderhaar had stated in a previous interview that Blackout was not his choice, it was Activision's choice, and that they had another name that him and some of the guys at the studio really liked. The community member wanted to know if he would share that name with us, and he said that he couldn't say it. Another question was about Avenged Sevenfold. They just created a zombie song for us, and they wanted to know if the band members could be playable characters in Blackout. Vonderhaar said that he's good friends with the band members from Avenged Sevenfold, and that they play video games on Xbox together, and they're in a crew together, and they all want it. The band members want it, Vonderhaar wants it, and they just have a lot of business stuff that they have to work out to make it happen. Someone asked if there would be some more side modes to return, like Dead Ops Arcade, and he said maybe they might return, and his response was pretty interesting. You'll have to watch the video to see it. Someone asked about the health system that is in multiplayer in Blackout versus zombies, and he said the zombies' health system is nothing like Blackout or multiplayer. It's totally different. Someone asked him about Classified and if we would be getting any information anytime soon, and he avoided the question entirely. The next question was about the transit crew and the transit bus, and if it's possible if we'll see some of those in Blackout in the future. He didn't answer the question about the transit crew, Victus, but he did talk about the transit bus. He said there are people at Treyarch that are fans of the transit bus, and there are things they need to get done before they can think about putting the bus in. So he's definitely aware of the transit bus being a request from the community, and there are people that work at Treyarch that love the idea too, but they have stuff they need to work on and get done before they can work on that. So to me, that sounds like it's a go. He also responded to this community member saying, "I hear you, I get it, I know you want it," and just kind of reassuring him. One of the last questions was from one of the Game Informer guys. He said he had spent the entire weekend looking for this melee weapon that Vonderhaar had hinted about in one of his other interviews. Vonderhaar had stated that there was going to be a special zombies melee weapon that was going to be put in, but he didn't say when. And I'm pretty sure that's what he said. I don't think I misheard him. He did say it would be a zombies melee weapon. Well, after the Game Informer guy heard about this in the interview, I guess he went and looked for it. And Vonderhaar said, yeah, it wasn't put into the beta. They're still working on it. There's some issues with it, and they're just trying to get it perfect before they add it. And the whole time he is talking about this in the podcast, Vonderhaar is making this side-to-side swinging motion like you would with some type of sword. So my guess is that they might be putting in Takeo's katana. That's the only thing that makes sense. And maybe this katana will be used for one of the zombie character quests to unlock them. In a previous interview, Vonderhaar had stated that to unlock these characters, you have to find a weapon that is associated with the character. So obviously, Takeo's katana would make a lot of sense. And it would be used to, obviously, unlock Takeo. Also, there was a leak on Reddit talking about some weapons that were associated with the premise crew that before you start the game, you're going to be able to load up a special weapon. And for Richtofen, it was like the Ragnaroks, Dempsey was the minigun, Nikolai was a flamethrower, and then Takeo had the katana. So it's possible that they will use those associations inside of Blackout for us to unlock those characters. But I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll see you next video.